So what did you enjoy most about being at sea?
I would have to say the sense of freedom. When you're out at sea, no one can control you out there. So it must be one of the last places on Earth where you're truly free. I'm going to loop around, Hubert.
Okay. We're going to do a tour around Hubert's boat and then go, yeah?
Yeah, I think so. It's a bit too windy for the drone, I think. Over.
Yeah, that's my my quiet alarm.
Is that enough right with alarms going off?
Yeah, just booting up the GPS position. Okay, I'll see you in a minute.
Okay, see ya. And we'll be standing by 1-6.
Standing 1-6.
Let's go. Let's get the anchor up. Ready? Are you ready? If you're not, here we come. If anything's going to happen, it's going to happen out there.
That was Paul, who you just heard on the radio. We met Paul while cruising in Thailand and quickly became great friends. His dream is to sail solo across the Indian Ocean on his beautiful red Oyster 53 SV making time.
Are you ready?
Since we're both eager to leave Thailand, we decided to set sail for the Maldives at the same time. Our speeds are pretty evenly matched and managed to stay in VHF contact for about the first 7 or 8 days of the trip. This is day one, pulling up anchor from Nai Harn Beach, Phuket. 1,500 nautical miles to go.
Thank you! Thank you so much! Sometime. Bye. Goodbye, land. See you. Bye. Now we bring the sails out. Watery road, Indian Ocean. Maldives, here we come.
Dreams are not the same for me. officially in international waters. Thai flag's coming down for the first time in a long time.
Standing by the shore, while your only open sea cannot take this anymore. Cannot take this anymore.
First sunset at sea. Lost the sight of land.
Cannot take this anymore.
God, it's flogging. So frustrating. I don't know what's more annoying, the sound of flogging sails or the engine. Not much wind, and waves are small, but they're just enough to roll the boat and cause a lot of noise. Jin is making sombreros for the sombrero passage tomorrow. We're having a competition with Paul to see who can make the best sombreros. This is Phuket. Sombrero passage is our sombrero channel right there between the Nicobar Islands. We should be there tomorrow, 24 hours from now. And it's also Taco Tuesday.
Yes, it is.
So we'll wear sombreros and eat tacos.
While going through the sombrero channel.
Yes. Right now, we're right in the middle of the sombrero.
It barely fits
in
the door.
Oh no. We're right in the middle of the sombrero channel. And Jin made us sombreros. Out of some old charts. Now all we need is some mariachi music. We haven't gone crazy yet. It's only day three.
What does he have?
This sombrero just stays on his head.
Probably when we said that, let's do a sombrero competition, he was probably really happy because he had a sombrero waiting for this moment. Not like us with a half taco on our head. And chili peppers. Oh, he's a huge sombrero. Oh my gosh. Paul, I think you win.
I think you won.
You won! Oh, you have a Rasta sombrero?
Ha ha! Okay, I tell you really bad story. Welcome to Jamaican Tat! Very, very sad story. I lost compass. I don't know where I am. I named this place Sombrero. Oh, Sombrero, Sombrero. Nope. I do dance, special dance, fine way. Pineapple, pineapple dance.
Amataka tambura kwe makore mazhinji ona rugare rwauya chose chose tofara.
Tuna!
catch of the trip. Nice skipjack. Tuna for dinner tonight.
Our first tuna. I'm making fish tacos. Seasoned, and I'm frying up some tuna pieces. And then we have some taco shells. They're in the oven now. And then we'll have tomato, onion, coriander, cheese, jalapenos, a little bit of chips on the side. It's going to be delicious. Hey, it's Taco Tuesdays! Oh, wait, maybe we need to wear a sombrero while we eat it.
It's early morning on day 4. And both pretty wrecked after last night. It's just been... It started out okay, beautiful sunset, but then the waves really picked up, but the wind did not, so we might have ran into a current or something, so the sails were just logging all over the place. Neither one of us really got any sleep whatsoever. We're moving a little bit faster now, not getting bashed, so it's more comfortable, but we're going off course. Further north than we would like to go right now. It's cold out here too. I'm sitting wrapped in a blanket. It's actually pretty cool. 700 miles to go to our next waypoint, which is on the southern tip of Sri Lanka. So we're making progress, just slowly.
So beautiful.
This is exactly how I dreamed sailing on the ocean would be. It's big waves, but comfortable.
It is. How fast are we going? Can you read it?
Between 6 and 7.
It's awesome.
Pretty steadily. Oh. We're doing good now. So day 4 started out pretty shit, but it's pretty good now. Hopefully it just continues like this for the rest of the way.
I hope so. Ups and downs. So we're going to have a sea salt and vinegar chip tasting at sea. We have a ridge cut sea salt and cider vinegar, a Kettle Brand sea salt and vinegar, and a Tyrell's Hand Cook English Crisps sea salt and cider vinegar. I have some ginger to cleanse our palate in between bites. And we'll see which is the winner. Here's the sea, and here's our sea salt and vinegar chips.
That one sucks. I don't like that one.
We had that one before, but you have to try it again. But we already know that one's gross. Not gross, but not as good as the other ones. Ginger. Okay, the next chip.
Alright, so who's the winner?
The Kettle Brand.
Kettle Brand.
Yum! Catch of the day from yesterday. Some sashimi.
Ooh.
Bam. We saw some wasabi. Wow.
That looked like a good piece to start with.
Is it good?
Yeah. It's awesome.
Hope to try to catch another one.
Mm-hmm. I've been trying to sleep on the passage because this couch is perpendicular to the rolling motion of the boat. I've just been trying to take a nap. It's not happening. You can see
camera never does it justice.
It's New Year's Eve, last day of 2020.
So Jen is setting up
decorations.
Yes.
So we got 15
seconds to 2021.
Yo, yo, yo.
Yeah. Count from 10.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Happy New Year! Yay! Yeah. Here you go. Cheers to a new year, hopefully. Better than 2020.
I think you're too far away to hear the siren.
You're gonna blast off some fireworks now.
Wow, guys.
2021. Wonder what that's gonna hold.
In the middle of Indian Ocean.
Bay of Bengal.
The land is 200-300 miles away from the land.
We're almost halfway across the Bay of Bengal.
Little of nowhere. So much
Paul, I wish you were here on Skylark with us.
Well, there's no one else around, we're just staying together.
That's true. It's like almost like you're here.
Yeah, old ships.
How many other ships can hear? The Indian Navy. Maybe you can see that on Channel 16 for me.
Happy New Year!
Wow, it's a spectacular sunrise this morning. January 1st, 2021.
Should we go call Paul and tell him the good news?
Sure.
Making time. This is Skylark over. He's not sleeping.
Probably. I keep on waking Paul up from his naps.
Skylark, go ahead. 7-2.
So, we're just calling to tell you something. Can you guess what it is?
Oh, yes, pregnant.
No.
No.
Jean's pregnant.
You've given up. You started drinking.
No. No, I would really like to.
You got another fish?
No. You got one more guess. Say again?
You saw an Indian submarine.
No. Come on, this should be easy. We're halfway!
Oh, we're halfway!
Yeah!
Shit. That's a blur. I can't work out what's going on.
I know. Neither can we.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy Christmas! Happy birthday to you!
Let me go relight it. Can you please hold this?
It's okay. There's too much wind.
No, there's not too much wind. I didn't mean that.
Don't say that. You should be happy it blows out your birthday candles.
Yeah. Okay.
You're welcome.
I think all we can say right now is this sucks. Smothering again by large waves. Again, we've been dodging swells all night long. Lightning, thunder, heavy rain.
Land ho! It's the Maldives!
We are in the Maldives, we're anchored. Let's get this engine off.
Next time on Outside Watch, we receive the warmest welcome from the Maldivian officials and are checked into the country. We also find the most picturesque lagoon and start living off the land.